फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम अगेन फॉर द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक. इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द इंडस्ट्रियल वेस्ट वाटर, इट्स कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स एंड द नीड ऑफ ट्रीटिंग द इंडस्ट्रियल वेस्ट वाटर. इन दिस पर्टिकुलर वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द मेथड्स ऑफ ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ द इंडस्ट्रियल वेस्ट वाटर. दीज आर द कंटेंट्स दैट वी आर गोइंग टू कवर ड्यूरिंग आवर डिस्कशन. इंट्रोडक्शन, then methods of treatment like equalization, neutralization, physical treatment, chemical treatment and biological treatment. Industrial wastewater have either too high a proportion of suspended solid, organic, dissolved organic and inorganic solid, BOD, alkalinity or acidity, and their different constituent will not be in the same proportion throughout, as they exist in the domestic wastewater. The important factor which affect the planning for industrial wastewater treatment plant are discontinuous flow and sometimes seasonally discharged wastewater, high concentration of pollutant and non-biodegradability and toxic substances, some pollution parameters. Treatment of the industrial wastewater generally consists of one or more of the following processes, like equalization, neutralization, physical treatment, chemical treatment and biological treatment. So let us see each and every treatment in detail. Equalization. When the characteristic of wastewater during the day and also when the discharge is either not uniform or else is continuous, equalization is necessary. The process of equalization consists of holding a wastewater for some predetermined time in the continuously mixed holding tank or basin so as to wastewater of uniform character and at uniform rate. The equalization needs the adequate storage. So the equalization, in short, if the flow is not continuous, in that case, and as the characteristic of industrial wastewater changes time to time, because of that, there should be a equal pH content, temperature, acidity, alkalinity and all, and different. So to equalize that, to came to the common concentration, the equalization is required. So such type of basins are constructed where the equalization is carried out. Then neutralization. This is necessary when the wastewater contains either excess alkali or excess solid and is achieved by the addition of either acid or alkali respectively. This may be done either in the equalization tank if conditions so permit, or else separate neutralization tank. So as we know, the industrial wastewater, it may be too acidic or too basic or alkali. Excess alkalis are present in the wastewater. So if the excess acidic water, industrial wastewater is there, in that case we have to neutralize that excess acidic water by adding some alkalis. So it is carried out in the neutralization tank or in the same equalization tank. If the wastewater is having excess alkali, in that case the acid should be added so that the water become neutral, and such type of neutralized effluent is further treated. Physical treatment. Physical treatment is similar to the primary treatment of domestic wastewater. Various processes that falls under these heads are screening, sedimentation, flotation and filtration. As we know, the physical word is coming, so all the physical separation is carried out during all these processes. Primary sedimentation becomes essential when the wastewater contains high percentage of soluble solids. Flotation is provided to remove the finer particle. In flotation, the rising air bubbles lift the finer particles to the surface, from where they are removed by the skimming. So screening is required for separation and removal of floating matters. After that, the sedimentation, where the large soluble solid can be removed, Flotation, as we know, the floating matters are removed, and filtration, again, all the matters can be filtered out in the filtration unit. Chemical treatments. Chemical treatment is one of the essential part in the treatment of industrial wastewater, especially for those which are amenable to the biological treatment. Sometimes physicochemical treatment is applied to the industrial wastewater. It means partly or in the first phase, the physical separation is carried out and then the chemical treatment is provided for the wastewater. Either in the absence of biological treatment or in conjunction with the biological treatment. Various chemical and physicochemical processes that are used for the industrial wastewater treatments are chemical coagulation or precipitation, hyperfiltration of reverse osmosis, chemical oxidation, adsorption, ion exchange, air stripping, electrolysis, and thermal reduction. So let us see each and every process in detail. Chemical coagulation or chemical precipitation. Chemical coagulation, as we know, adopted in treating raw waste water supply and helps in sedimentation of unsatiable micro and colloidal impurities which get absorbed in the gelatinous flow formed by the chemical reaction between the coagulant or between the coagulant and alkalis present in the raw water. However, in the treatment of industrial wastewater, such chemicals are added to help out the precipitation of dissolved and troublesome impurities such as phosphorus, phosphorus compound, etc. This process is then popularly known as chemical precipitation. So, if you see the figure of chemical coagulation or precipitation, the suspended solid which are not readily satiable or could not settle, in that case, the chemicals are added from and then the flocculation or the flocculation is carried out, and during that the chemical, due to the addition of chemical, flock formation will occur, and as this flock is heavier than water will get start settling easily at the bottom, and thereby we can remove the water, supernatant water from the top, and sludge can be removed readily. So this is called as a chemical coagulation or precipitation. Then reverse osmosis. In reverse osmosis treatment process, the wastewater containing dissolved salt are filtered through the semi-permeable membrane at a pressure higher than the osmotic pressure. So here the salts, if the wastewater is containing dissolved salt, then those salts are removed or filtered through the semi-permeable membrane at a high pressure than the osmotic pressure. So this is what is happening in the reverse osmosis. Then the chemical oxidation. In chemical oxidation, chemical are like chlorine and ozone are used to reduce the substances like ammonia and cyanide, etc. from the wastewater, in addition to reducing BOD load on biological treatment. So the oxidation or the oxygen reducing or reduction chemicals are used, like chlorine and ozone are used to reduce the substances like ammonia and cyanide, etc. So this is what happening in the chemical oxidation, where effluent is entered from the bottom, then chemicals are added, and the treated effluent as a supernatant is taken out from the tank. Fluidized beds are also provided, where fluidized beds are laden with the chlorine and ozone. They will come in intimate contact with the wastewater and thereby causes the oxidation of the chemical. Then adsorption. Adsorption is generally used to remove non-biodegradable organic material, color and odor from the wastewater. The process involves passing the pre-treated wastewater through the bed of activated carbon. So this is the assembly in which adsorption is carried out. Adsorption means the adherence or the filtering matter, filtration of the water through the adsorbing material. like activated carbon and all. So the color, odor and the organic material, non-biodegradable, obviously will get adhere on the surface of the activated carbon, and thereby it will cause the separation of such matters from the effluent, influent, and then effluent is taken out and the adsorbent are regularly and routinely replaced. Then deionization, it is also called as a ion exchange process. Deionization involves a similar passage of the wastewater through the bed of synthetic ion exchange resin, where some undesirable cations or anions of the wastewater get exchanged from sodium or hydrogen ions of the resin. Please read ions instead of tons. So ions of the resin. So if you see, the effluent is entered from the top. Resin like zeolite or synthetic resins are used. From that, the effluent is passed through where the cations and anions are get separated and the clear effluent is taken out from the bottom. Air stripping. In air stripping, the liquid waste is poured down through a packed tower equipped with an air boiler blower at the bottom. This method is a modification of aeration process and used for removal of gases from the wastewater. Here the air stripping means the effluent is came in contact with the air, where air is blown from the bottom, whereas effluent is coming from the top. When it comes in contact with that, the undesirable gases present in the wastewater will get released and will get cleaned in this particular process, and the clear effluent is taken out from the bottom. Then the electrodialysis. In electrodialysis treatment process, dissolved salt from the wastewater are separated by passing an electric current through the wastewater tank installed with the ion exchange membrane. This treatment process also requires some pretreatment as it required in reverse osmosis process. So the electrodes are used where the wastewater or effluent is framed from the fed from the bottom, where it will come in contact with the anode and cathode and the different electrodes which are charged, and due to which the undesirable pollutants or the cations and anions present in the wastewater get attracted towards the electrode, and thereby it can cause the removal and the separation of the undesirable ions, and the wastewater, treated wastewater, is taken out from the top, whereas the concentrate which are get accumulated in the chambers, it is taken out, which is usually called as a brine. Then the thermal reduction. Thermal reduction requires burning and consequent oxidation of some toxic and refractive substances like organic cyanide, which may be present in certain specific industrial wastewater. So it is very clear that here literally we are burning the wastewater to reduce the toxicity of the organic cyanides if it is present in the industrial wastewater. Then the last is biological treatment. This is restored to only when the industrial wastewater contains the large quantity of biodegradable substances. Usually, the industrial wastewater does not contain the organic matter or the biodegradable organic matter. If it is present, or we can say the if the industrial wastewater and domestic wastewater are combined and taken to the common effluent treatment plant, in that case, biological treatments are necessary. Now, apart from that, if the BOD divided by COD ratio of the industrial water is more than 1, it is biologically treatable. As already we have discussed about the BOD divided by COD, which is also called as a treatability index. Actually, the formula for treatability index is somewhat different. But if the BOD divided by COD is greater than 1, it denotes that the BOD is more, because BOD is coming at the numerator. So if it is more than 0.6, so it is direct indication that the biologically biodegradable matters are more in the wastewater. In that case, the biological treatment is recommended. If the ratio is less than 0.6, please write points. Please read 0.6. But it is up to 0.3. Acclimatization is necessary before the biological treatment. So if the COD is greater, in that case, this ratio will go to the less than the 0.6 or even up to 0.3. In that case, the acclimatization is required before the biological treatment. Now, what is mean by acclimatization? If, however, the ratio is less than 0.3, biological treatment is not necessary. Acclimatization is the process of seeding or raising the initial microbial population under the control condition by gradual exposure of the wastewater in increasing concentration. So acclimatization, it means the seeding or the addition of the microorganism from the externally. Various biological treatment methods that can be used are activated sludge process, trickling filter, oxidation pond, aerated lagoon, oxidation ditch, and oxidation lagoon followed by aerated lagoons. Amongst these, the trickling filter proves better than the activated sludge process since the filter can handle a number of toxic waste quite satisfactorily. So, in this particular discussion, we have understood and discussed the different methods that can be used, like equalization, neutralization, physical treatment, where the physical separation is carried out, then the chemical treatment like reverse osmosis, ion exchange, chemical precipitation, air stripping, etc., and the biological process. So as per the condition, the different methods or the combination of different processes are used to treat the industrial wastewater. Thank you for watching.